الحمد لله، الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه، ملء السماوات وملء الأرض وملء ما شاء ربي من شيء بعد. الحمد لله الذي جعل الرزق والأجل بيده لا بيد أحد سواه، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا وحبيبنا وقرة أعيننا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله، أدى الأمانة وبلغ الرسالة ونصح الأمة، تركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. وبعد، عباد الله، أوصيكم ونفسي الخاطئة بتقوى الله، ومن يتق الله يجعل له مخرجا ويرزقه من حيث لا يحتسب. عباد الله، توكلوا على الله، ومن يتوكل على الله فهو حسبه، ومن يتوكل على الله فهو حسبه. اللهم اجعلنا من المتقين المتوكلين، آمين. Dear brothers, respected sisters, all praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and peace be upon his servant and last messenger, our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I bear witness there is no God worthy of worship but Allah. I bear witness that Muhammad, his servant and last messenger. Reminding myself first, my dear brothers and respected sisters, to fear Allah, just Allah, and place our trust on Him, just on Him. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those who fear Him, and placing their trust just on Him. Ameen. Dear brothers, respected sisters, whoever take a look for the humanity situation, none can argue with me that the whole humanity in general live in disaster situation. Muslims community, especially Muslims community, we live in a very special disaster situation. ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. We are moving from problems to another one. Fighting, killing, wars, earthquake, floods, hurricanes. Every morning, all what we care about to hear how many been killed yesterday. Death become just number, just number. How many been killed yesterday? And especially the Muslims Ummah, we are going through a big test, a big test. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who pass this test. Today I'm going to focus in Myanmar, Rohingya, Burma, our brothers there. Those who are being burned alive. They burning them alive. Not just that, they force the parents to put their babies in the fire by themselves. Over 515,000 persons flee to Bangladesh borders, running away from burning, from torturing, from killing. Add to this the human trafficking problems. Among 515,000, there is 190,000 children. Among those children, 1,000 missing so far, and thousands of women as well, because of the human trafficking problems. They locate some of those children and women in neighborhood countries like Thailand, and they use them for drugs and other problems. ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. This is the situation for our brothers there. Recently, Bangladesh even, they did not allow even Muslim organizations to work there for reason or another. So this is the situation there. This is the Muslims' ummah situation all over. And this and that, all of what happening around us as a Muslims community should not put us down. Instead, we should stand strongly and hold tight to our faith, to our religion, Islam. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he went through more difficulties than this. He was alone sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Most, if not all, of his followers were slaves, have no power, no authority. But he did not give up. He did not compromise. And the same situation for us. If we are in Allah's side, you don't need to worry. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, وَيَمْكُرُونَ وَيَمْكُرُ اللَّهُ وَاللَّهُ خَيْرُ الْمَاكِرِينَ They are planning, Allah is planning too. And Allah is the best planner. Allah is the best planner. If you are in Allah's side, don't worry. Yes, they are attacking Muslims community. They are publishing over 65,000 publishments every year against Islam to ruin the image of Muslims and Islam. They are killing and fighting and burning alive Muslims community everywhere. Especially in Myanmar. But all of this should not put us down. Yes, we live as strangers. And we are proud that we are strangers. That reminds me of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam hadith. بَدَأَ الْإِسْلَامُ غَرِيبًا وَسَيَعُودُ غَرِيبًا كَمَا بَدَأَ Islam did start as a stranger. And it will get back as a stranger. فَطُوبَ لِلْغُرَبَى A pleasure in use for those strangers. Who are those, Prophet Muhammad? He said, those who do good while others fail to. Yes, we are strangers. It doesn't mean anything if we are in Allah's side. If we are in Allah's side, you don't need to worry. In spite of all of what they are doing, to ruin the image of Islam, still Islam is the fastest growing religion in the world. Why? Because this is Allah's plan. This is Allah's plan. Never compromise. Never give up. Never lose the hope in Allah's victory. And quote me for this statement. I keep repeating it. Islam is coming. Whether they like it or not. Whether we work for it or not. But Islam is coming, Islam is coming. They like it or they don't. We work for it or not. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it very clear in the Quran. وَإِن تَتَوَلَّوْا يَسْتَبْدِلِ اللَّهُ قَوْمًا غَيْرَكُمْ ثُمَّ لَا يَكُونُوا أَمْثَالَكُمْ If you don't do your job, Allah will replace you with better ones. It's easy on Allah. Allahumma istamilna wa la tastabdilna. Say ameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala use us and not replacing us. For this, don't let what is going around us disappoint you or make you lose hope. You need to know that this is Allah's plan for this Muslim's ummah. We are going through difficulties, that's fine. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam before us, he did that. And he went through a lot of difficulty. But all of difficulties did not put him down sallallahu alaihi wasallam or made him compromise or give up any part of his faith. They went to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasallam when he was in the top of weaknesses days. And they told him, Ya Muhammad, ماذا تريد? What you want from us? You want money? We'll give it to you. You want a high status? We'll assign you as a king of all Arabs. لو أردت مالا مل أعطيناك لو أردت جاها ملكناك. What you want? Then he said, والله لو وضعوا الشمس في يميني والقمر في شمالي على أن أترك هذا الدين أو أموت دونه. I swear by Allah, if they put the sun in my right hand and the moon in my left one to abandon this religion, I won't. He did not, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Yes, he was in top of frequencies days. It doesn't mean anything. As long as he, you and me in Allah's side, we doing what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala order us to do, then you don't need to worry. This is Allah's plan. He did not give up. More than that, they went to him, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, offering him. And his followers were few, no power, no country to support him. And they told him, Ya Muhammad, na'budu ilahaka yawman wa ta'budu ilahana yawman. Oh Muhammad, we are willing to worship your God one day, you worship our just next one, 50-50. He did not respond, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Oh Muhammad, we are willing to worship your God one full week, you worship our just one day a week. Look at them, did not respond, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Oh Muhammad, na'budu ilahaka shahran wa ta'budu ilahana yawman. We are willing to worship your God one full month, and you worship our just one day a month. One day a month. He looked at them, no response, alayhi salatu wassalam. Oh Muhammad, we are willing to worship your God one full year, and you worship our just one day a year. One day a year. He looked at them and start reciting what Allah revealed to him, chapter Al-Kafirun. قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا الْكَافِرُونَ لَا أَعْبُدُ مَا تَعْبُدُونَ وَلَا أَنْتُمْ عَابِدُونَ مَا أَعْبُدُ وَلَا أَنَا عَابِدٌ مَا عَبَدْتُمْ وَلَا أَنْتُمْ عَابِدُونَ مَا أَعْبُدُ لَكُمْ دِينُكُمْ وَلِيَ دِينِ. الله أكبر. Oh Muhammad, say to those disbelievers, I worship not what you worship, nor you worship what you worship. He confirmed this statement twice, then he said, you have your own way, and I have mine. And I have mine. He did not give up one day a year for kufr, for shaitan. While he was in the top of weaknesses days, he did not compromise, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Why? Because he trusted Allah the most. Do we trust Allah the most? Everything in this world under Allah's control. Everything in Allah's hand. Whatever they do, it's Allah's plan for this ummah to test us, to see who will compromise, who will give up, and who will stand strongly, protect himself, his community, his faith. Never ever be hopeless of Allah's mercy. A day will come for this deen, for this ummah. Islam will enter every small and big corner in this globe. That's what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam promised in the authentic hadith. And we trust this hadith. We trust what he said sallallahu alayhi wasallam. They are doing planning, plotting, conspiracy against Islam. Still, Islam is the fastest growing religion in the world. Remember my words, Islam is coming. They like it or they don't. We work for it or not. Make sure that you work for Islam. Make sure that you never give up or compromise your faith. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, when he immigrated from Mecca to Medina, Quraysh sent after him everyone, 100 camels for whoever bring Muhammad dead or life. And Suraq ibn Malik, he reached him a few feet between both. Suraq looked at his horse drowning in the sand. وفي رواية غرقت حتى عنقها. This his horse drowned until its neck. He now deep in his heart he wants to save himself only. But listen to what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said. He told him, Ya Suraqa, ارجع ولك سواري كسرى. Oh Suraqa, go back. And I promise you with the bracelet of Kisra. La ilaha illallah. You deliver such a great promise while you were alone in the middle of the desert. Have no country, no power, no authority. And you promised with the bracelet of Kisra? Yes, he did. And this is a message to Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, his friend, and to every Muslim until the Day of Judgment. Never be hopeless of Allah's mercy, of Allah's victory. Never. This faith, this religion protected by Almighty Allah, the Creator, Al-Qadir, Al-Qahir, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not countries, not United Nations. It's protected by Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You don't need to worry about it. You need to do our job, if each one of us do our job, and first and last, it's in Allah's hand. But never ever compromise, never ever give up. This promise over sallallahu alayhi wa sallam days did not fulfill man. They did not, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not fulfill the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam promise over his days. Then Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu days did not fulfill. Over Umar's days radiallahu anhu, they conquered al-Madain. They brought a lot of wealth and put it before Umar in the masjid. He looked at that and started crying. And he said, Wallahi lalladhi ahdara hadha la rajulun amin. I swear by Allah who brought this wealth is an honest man. Hudhayfa ibn al-Yaman stood up and he was the one. He said, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, عَفَفْتَ فَعَفَّتْ رَعِيَّتُكَ وَلَوْ خُنْتَ لَخَانَتْ رَعِيَّتُكَ. O Amir al-Mu'mineen, you are an honest person, your people become an honest people like you. Otherwise, they will be otherwise. Then Umar radiallahu anhu said, give me bracelet of Kisra. They give it to him. Call Suraqa for me. They did. He said, this is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam promise. More than 13 years. This is the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam promise. He wear it, radiyallahu anhu, and start walking proudly and showing people the bracelet of Kisra. One of the companions, he said, this is amazing. The stranger things I saw in my life. A Bedouin wearing the bracelet of Kisra. Yes, but this is Islam. This is great religion. Never ever be hopeless of Allah's victory, of Allah's mercy. You need to trust Allah's promises. Islam is coming. They like it or they not. Whether we work for it or not. Remember these words. For this we need to stand strongly and be proud of our faith. Yes, we are strangers, like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam described us. That doesn't mean anything. It doesn't mean anything. We are proud that we are strangers. And they treated us as strangers. Among four people in this globe, one of them Muslim, 1.7 billion Muslim in this globe, still, when they saw a Muslims, when they see a Muslim's woman wearing the scarf, they look at her, what she is doing, why she is doing this. When they see one of us perform his prayer, everybody starts staring what he's doing. 1.7 billion Muslim in this globe, and they still have no clue. They don't want to know about Islam. They don't want to know about your faith. Because they know Islam means justice. Islam mean freedom. Islam mean equality. And they don't like these things. They don't like it. And they know what's going to happen to them if Islam take over. They know this. So be proud of your faith. Be strong. Protect your community, your faith, your ummah. Never give up or be hopeless of Allah's victory and Allah's mercy. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام once he saw Adi ibn Hatim al-Ta'i before he became Muslim. And he told him, Ya Adi, O Adi, أعلم ما الذي يمنعك من الإسلام. I know what prevents you from Islam, Ya Adi. I know. إنك تقول في نفسك, you say to yourself, إن المسلمين ضعفاء فقراء مقهورين. Muslims are poor, weak, not respected. This is our description these days, subhanallah. It's the same. إنك تقول في نفسك إن المسلمين ضعفاء فقراء مقهورين. You say to yourself that Muslims are poor, weak, not respected. يا عدي, أو عدي. A day will come for this ummah. تسير الضعين من حضر موت إلى مكة لا تخشى إلا الله. وفي رواية والذئب على الغنم. A day will come for this ummah when the woman traveling from Mecca to, from Hadramaut to Mecca have no fear but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya Adi, O Adi, inna qusura Kisra satumlaku biyad al-muslimin. Kisra's treasures will be captured by the Muslims' ummah. Adi ibn Hatim al-Ta'i got shocked. Open his eyes. And look at the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said, Kisra ibn Hurmuz. The Prophet alayhi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Kisra ibn Hurmuz, Kisra ibn Hurmuz, Kisra ibn Hurmuz. Adi ibn Hatim al-Ta'i, he said, I did see this with my own eyes. Yes, we are weak. We are poor. As a community, as an ummah, we are poor. We are not respected. They are plotting and planning every day, daytime and nighttime against Islam. If someone run over a dog by his car, it will take more space in the media than our brothers and sisters in Myanmar. A very small incident in the train station in UK, they talk about it more than what they did about Myanmar. Thousands of people being burned alive. They force mothers to put her baby in the fire, to destroy her heart, to kill her alive. 515,000 Muslims flee to Bangladesh borders. Have no food, no shelters, no medical, nothing. Even recently, Bangladesh closed their borders, so there is a lot of people, good number of Muslims, ummah, stuck in between, and they live in the shallow waters. They cannot go back, and they are not allowed to get in. This is the Muslims, ummah situation. That's a big test for them and for us as well, to see what we are going to do. I know Muslims' ummah situation is too difficult. We are moving from problems to another one. We did not finish the Syrian problems, or the Palestinian one, or the Iraqi one, or the Yemeni one, or the Somali one, or. I know that, but this is our destiny. We need to stand united, help each others. We need to stand strongly and protect ourselves and do our best to help our brothers there. It's a test for both, for those and for us, what we are going to do. But the bottom line, never ever be hopeless of Allah's mercy. Never be hopeless of Allah's victory. This Islam is coming. Whether they like it or not, whether we work for it or not. We ask Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the real understanding of our religion. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us and our parents as well. We ask Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy on our brothers everywhere. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant this community more unity, more tranquility and self-control. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فيا فوز المستغفرين أستغفر الله. الحمد لله حمد الشاكرين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. All praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and peace be upon his servant and last messenger, our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Dear brothers, respected sisters, whatever circumstances we live in, that should not put us down. And this should make us more, grant us more unity and take care of each others and help each others. As I said, for reason or another, Bangladesh prevents some Muslims organization to work there. May I ask you please to come forward to allow our brothers standing in the back. Please, أفسحوا يفسح الله لكم. Come forward, please. The situation there, it's very difficult. As I said, add to the killing, fighting, burning alive, the human trafficking problems. Thousands of children and women kidnapped, and nobody knows where are they now but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Lack of clean water, lack of food, lack of medical, lack of shelters. Lack of shelters. 515,000. It's not a small number. It's not a small number. And they need your help. And alhamdulillah, since our partner in UK, Human Appeal, have an office long time ago in Bangladesh, that's give us an access to keep working there. And alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, a few weeks ago, one of our representatives, he went there with the staff from UK to make sure that we are doing our job right. And there is a small video outside in the table. You can see it, what we are doing there. We're having partners for many reasons. Number one, they have an office there. Number two, to lower the administration cost. And alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, we are taking care of thousands of people there. $350, you can buy a tent fit for 10 people. $180, you can buy food package to feed a family for 1 month. Thousands of families. Over 500,000 people, and the number is increasing every day. Every day. Please allow me for a few minutes after the speech, after the prayer, to stand before you and ask for your help. And we have a table outside with a credit card machine. You can do whatever you can. Because me, you, everyone will stand before Allah. He will ask us about those brothers who've been burned alive. هذا وقد أمركم الله بأمر بدأ بنفسه وثنى بملائكة قدسه وثلث بكم أيها المؤمنين فقال إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما لبيك اللهم صلي وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم اجمع شملنا وحد صفنا وسدد رمينا ولا تجعل بأسنا بيننا شديد. اللهم إنا نستودعك إخوة لنا في مينمار، كن معهم ولا تكن عليهم. اللهم شافي مرضاهم وداوي جرحاهم وتقبل شهداءهم. اللهم عليك بالظالمين فإنهم لا يعجزونك وأنت رب العالمين. اللهم أرنا فيهم عجائب قدرتك، اللهم أرنا فيهم عجائب قدرتك، اللهم أرنا فيهم عجائب قدرتك. ربنا اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وللمؤمنين يوم يقوم الحساب. اللهم أعط كل واحد منا سؤله واقض حاجته وفرج كربته، وصل اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وأنت يا أخي أقم الصلاة.